Hey, y'all, what's going on? Just want to pop in here real quick. Yesterday, I cooked curry chicken. I've cooked it, you know, I have a couple of videos over here where I've cooked it before. And I get the popular question, even on other things that I cook, what is the recipe? I don't cook from recipes, but I do, like, if I'm cooking something, even if it's not the first time, I do go online and just Google it. And I just to get an idea of, like, maybe time-wise and things like that. But as far as seasonings and stuff, I have a cupboard full of seasonings that I would use on any food. I mean, certain foods that are like fish, I wouldn't use the same kind of seasoning that I put on, you know, chicken, because, yeah, it's a different kind of taste. But I believe in anything you cook to taste. Now, with curry chicken, you know, like, the thing that you want to stand out is the curry. Now, I use two kind of curry. I use Guyanese curry and I use, you know, West Indian curry. It gives it a different flavor. You don't have to do that, but again, it's up to you. I don't use a lot of fresh seasonings because I don't cook often. So I don't keep that in my home. So, but if you're with curry chicken, the, you know, simple things, you know, your onions, tomato, scallion, if you want thyme, cilantro, those fresh things, you know, to season your chicken with. Cool beans, you could do that. And you can even add some of the powdered stuff, you know, with that. And then you put your, you know, I season my chicken with curry. Some people, they cook it and they add the curry in the pot after. I season it with the curry and I let it, for me, I like it to sit for at least 2 days. You know, I do it late. Say I do it late Monday night, I'll cook it on Wednesday. So, you know, so the chicken can absorb the seasoning. Now, I'm going to put the, you've seen the video, but I'll put the link somewhere so you can go by and watch it. It's the quickest thing to make. What I do first, I put the oil in the pan. I put the chicken, you know, let it heat up. Then you put the chicken in there to brown it. Not to, you know, brown it, so you can brown it on both sides. So you're basically coating the outside. You're not cooked. It's not cooked inside. You're just browning it, so, you know. So you put it, heat the pan, you put the chicken in. I use boneless chicken because I like boneless chicken. I can't stand it. But it's your choice, your preference. Brown them on both sides. When that is done, when you finish browning it, you add water to it to cook it down. Now, how much water do you add? Again, that's up to you. I like to add a lot of water. My mother taught me, you know, you add it, you gradually add it. But me, I like to make sure that whatever kind of chicken in there, I just make sure it comes above the chicken level that I have in the pan, the meat level. Now, again, the reason why I put more water in it, because I like a lot of gravy. Not saying I'm putting the whole, but I like a lot of gravy. So then you let that cook. I put the fire on medium, so it brings it to a boil, so it goes quick, you know. So again, it depends on how long, you know, when you're trying to eat, whatever. I put it on a medium heat, so, you know, the boiling in the pot is pretty quick. You keep checking and stirring, you know, making sure that everything is happening right, and you will see that the water is going to start to take the color of the curry. It's going to start to change because that's the seasoning, you know, mixing into the water. And it's making kind of like a stew, if you want to call it that. Now, as it's starting to take on the color of the water, you need to taste that, you know, take a different spoon, not the one you're mixing it with. Take a spoon and taste that, the gravy, to see if it's the flavor that you want. Because, yeah, it's going to be in the, whatever you're tasting in that water, in the water, the gravy, whatever the hell you want to call it, that's how the chicken tastes then. Because it's coming out of your chicken. So, you taste it. As you're cooking, taste it. And whatever is missing, you add it at that time. And you mix it and you let it boil, keep boiling to cook all that seasoning. Because you don't want to put it in there and have the seasonings clump up in the corner. You let it boil out, let it cook out. Alrighty. So, as that's going, you taste again after that's done. Again, I can't give you amount of minutes. It's like, it took me to cook, because being that I didn't have to season, let's say a half an hour to 45 minutes. So as that's boiling, you know, it's bubbling up. You should have peeled a potato. I use one potato. You can use as much potato as you want. Now, the reason why potato was used is to thicken that gravy. Because if you don't, it'll be a little watery. But then you put the potato in, it thickens the gravy. Hey, what are you doing? You know, who wants watery gravy? Ew. But yeah, my mother taught me that. You put the potato in to thicken the gravy. It's not how long you keep the potato in. Basically, you know you're good as you see in the gravy thicken. And if you take a spoon or whatever and you push it in the potato and it just smashes, you're good. You're done. It's done. Basically that's all. That's it. It's pretty simple. I mean you do it a couple of times. I mean, the one I had yesterday was business. Oh my Jesus! Again, click here to see that video. And try it, and hopefully you enjoy it. So hopefully that's helped some. Yeah, all right. Rice and peas. Now, I'm Jamaican. I grew up in a home. Yeah, my mother makes everything from scratch. But coming into this age, I mean, there's shortcuts. She also uses with the from scratch stuff, and she's taught me this. I know how to do the whole from the night making the peas, soaking the pot. Da 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 da. Look, I ain't got time for all that. So, here's a quick way to do rice and peas. No, I'm not going to show you. I'm just going to tell you. Pick whatever white rice that you like, or if you use brown rice, but whatever rice the white rice you like, you buy. It could be Uncle Ben's, it could be Carolina, whatever the hell it is. Now, some people don't know how to cook white rice. I don't understand. The instructions come on the bag or on the thing. If you follow instructions, you'll be fine, but you got to keep, check it, you got to stir it. And again, you got to test it because, you don't want it you don't want it hard and you don't want it mushy. If you follow directions, it should come out right. I don't know. I don't know what to tell you about white rice. But there is one trick. As, the water is evaporating, take foil paper, put it on top of the pot, take the cover and put it on it so it steams the rice. Yeah, it comes fluffy. That's something my dad taught me. All right, so the peas. Stewing or soaking overnight, blah, blah. Goya, oh boy. Go buy however much peas you want. Go buy Goya. Goya makes a great line. I like to buy, I use two of them. Sometimes I use the pigeon or sometimes I use the red one. But I like it when it's seasoned with pork. Hallelujah. Yes. So, you make your rice, you boil the beans, the peas. After the peas finish boiling, don't just pour the peas in the rice. That's gross. It'll be slimy because it's juice from the peas. Take a spoon that has holes in it, Take the peas, put it in the rice. Mix that up. Now, when you mix that up, you check the texture of it if that is fine for you. Again, everything is, to me, is taste, trial and error, taste, and it's how you want it. After put the peas and you mix it all up. If that is fine for you, you also taste it. If it's fine, you're good. But then the juice is left over from the peas. So what you can do is, as you mix, you can add some of that juice to the rice and you mix it up. Honey child, if you don't tell nobody, they think you made them peas set overnight. Yes! There's a lot of simplicity to these wonderful Caribbean dishes. So it's not that hard. It's not that hard. So again, hopefully that has helped. Goya or Boya. Yeah.